The people that you meet at Davos are not all rich by any means. There's a lot of academics, and there's a lot of, so they're educated, certainly, they speak English. They're rather worldly, but I wouldn't argue that they're all rich, because they're just, it's not the case. But there's a lot of diversity here, and that, of course, you know, comes from travel. The people at Davos travel a lot. Now, that's a privilege that I think, so far, has been, you know, not so well shared across humanity. Most people in the world work and live not very far from where they were born. What we've found is that if we allow young people to move around, which today's technology in terms of transport and communications allows more than it ever has, we can turn the world into a beauty contest of countries, companies, cities, vying to attract young people. None of these entities, whether it's an organization, a government, a city, a company, none of them can thrive without young people. So let's just put the pressure on them to attract those young people. And if young people are ready to embrace a certain form of nomadism, after thousands of years of becoming sedentary, then that's a world where they can really have their voice be heard.